Follow this jean sewing tutorial to the end. I cover every step. I will show you the very best techniques. This time I'm making selvedge jeans, but the techniques apply to all styles. My pattern is interactive, which means there are links to guides and information. Download it from angelakane.com. Gather together. Zip threads, interfacing and pocketing. And your Japanese narrow loom selvedge denim. Although you can use any denim for this pattern. Assemble the pattern. And cut out your fabric. The pattern is ready for marking up. Snip notches and tail tack dots. Firstly, stay stitch these edges. The fly zip. Mark the center front on the left front. Remove the fly extension, but leave the seam allowance. Trim the seam allowance from the interfacing and iron on. Position the interfacing for the right front and iron on. Position the left fly extension. Pin then baste and machine. Press the seam towards the extension and trim above the dot. Place the edge of the zip tape just under 1 inch, 2.25 centimeters, right of the center front line. Using a zipper foot, needle to the right, machine close to the tape edge. With the needle to the left, machine a second row close to the teeth. Place the two fronts right sides together. Let the zip fall into its correct position and pin. Machine the two rows as before, starting at the end of the zip this time. One along the outer edge, needle to the right. And one row close to the teeth, needle to the left. Stitch the crotch seam from the dot to the inside leg seam. Snip to the dot on the right side only. Neaten the edge of the left fly facing and the crotch seam in one go. Start stitching from the bottom, it's easier. The zip is in the perfect position. Press the front fold. Top stitch along this fold as far as you can go. The layers underneath are pushed out of the way. A word about top stitching. I usually recommend regular thread in the bobbin and top stitching thread in the needle. This time I'm using strong thread in the bobbin and in the needle, which is working well on this heavy duty denim. Experiment with threads, but always have both top and bottom tension tight. Mark in the top stitching line 1¾ inches, 4.4 centimeters from the center front, curving round well below the zip end to the dot. Top stitch along the guideline. For a double row, turn, stitch up a couple of stitches. Turn again and return to the top. Use a stitch compensation tool to keep the foot level. Look for this on sewing supplies on my patterns page. Now for the fly guard. Fold in half, wrong sides together. Neaten the lower edge. Place behind the zip with the fold to the right. Turn over. Pin these edges together. Zigzag or overlock, joining and neatening the raw edges. Keep everything flat and in position. Top stitch through all layers close to this edge. Using a zipper foot, stitch as far as you can go. That is the fly zip completed. Finally, for this stage, with the seam allowance pressed towards the left front, double top stitch the crotch seam. Meet up with the previous stitching. And then back to the inside leg seam. Then do some fancy bar tacks. This will secure the fly guard in place. Change to regular thread for this. Use a narrow zigzag and a short stitch length. Trim up at the waistline. The front pockets. We have the pocket bag, the side front, the pocket facing, and the coin pocket. Trim the lower edge seam allowance of the side fronts to a quarter of an inch, that's less than 1 centimetre. And the same with the pocket facings. Zigzag or overlock those edges to neaten. Pin the pieces in place onto the pocket bags. Machine in place. Trim away the pocket bag from under the pocket facing, leaving a half an inch, 1.75 centimetre seam allowance. Turn under the edge and press. Machine along this edge. Next, the coin pocket. Fold the pattern along the top line for a template and mark the line with chalk. Neaten the other three edges. Fold down along the top line and press. And fold in the seam allowance. Machine a double row of top stitching along the top. Turn under the seam allowance along the left-hand edge. This is the only edge on show. Place the coin pocket so that the right-hand edge is hidden. To sew in place, double top stitch the outside edge. Stitch down the remaining edges. Pin both pockets to the fronts. Stitch the curved pocket seams. Clip these seams. Turn through and press. Double top stitch the top of the pocket. Fold the pockets inside out to stitch just the lower edges. Pin ready for machining. Just machine to here. Once machined, turn the pockets through. Press the edge and machine. Now, from the front, make sure notches and dots line up. Pin the layers together. Stitch just inside the seam allowance to hold everything in place. And the same with the other side. The jeans backs. Firstly, we will add the pockets. The top corners will line up with these dots. Mark the top fold. As before, turn down the seam allowance and then the top fold and press. Turn in the seam allowance. You can just press. I like to pin and baste these turnings to make sure the corners are tucked in. Line up the top of the pockets with the dots and pin. It's usual to have a slight angle at the corners to keep the seam allowance hidden. You can emphasize this in the stitching and make it a feature. The back yoke. Next, we will join the back yokes to the backs. Make sure the longer sides are towards the center. Pin matching the notch. Pay attention to the curve. Machine and then zigzag to neaten. Press the seam down. double top stitch. Join the backs, matching notches and seams. Overlock or zigzag to neaten. The back seam is pressed towards the right back. Double top stitch the back seam. Join fronts and backs. Firstly, we will join the inside leg seam. Line up the seam, not the top stitching. I have the seam allowance pressed in opposite directions to reduce the layers. This is heavy duty denim being sewn on a domestic sewing machine. Neaten the edges. Press the seam towards the front, then double top stitch. This is where it will be difficult. If the seam allowances were pressed in the same direction, it won't be noticed. The outside selvage seam. So with right sides together, we will pin and machine the outside seam. Match the notches. We will be clipping the seam allowance here and pressing the seam open below. So measure down about an inch, 2.5 centimetres, below the pocket. You only actually have to clip the front seam allowance. We'll neaten the seam above and press it open below. The seam here is pressed towards the back, and below the selvage edge will be on show when the cuff is turned up. To finish the outside seam, we top stitch to just below the pockets. I am getting the use out of my stitch compensating tool. This one is from Bernina. See the links to useful sewing resources on angelacane.com/sewing-supplies. We are now ready to attach the waistband. The waistband. The belt loops first. I'll use a bias tape tool and some spare fabric. Cut strips of just under 1 inch, 2.5 centimetres. We need about 25 inches, 60 centimetres altogether. Neaten the edges. Cut a point to help you load the tape maker. Such a handy gadget. Then top stitch both edges. Cut into 5 inch, 13 centimetre lengths. We only need 5. Make sure you have marked these notches. I have ironed on the interfacing. Belt loop placement. Place the front loops at a point 3/4 of the way between centre front and the start of the pocket. For the back loops, around 1.5 inches, 4 centimeters, behind the side seam. And one at the centre back. Attach at the waistline with a few back and forward stitches. On the waistband, fold in and press the seam allowance of the unnotched edge. Pin the waistband in place. Match notches to centre front and back and the side seams. Pin all around ready for stitching. I like to baste to ensure accuracy here. It's a good idea to use a seam allowance guide here. An accurate seam allowance will give you an even width waistband. The seam lines up nicely here, and the position of the zip is perfect. This seam needs to be pressed up towards the waistband. Then we stitch both ends with the seam allowances folded in. I find the zipper foot useful here. So that is both ends stitched. Mitre the corners and trim the seam allowance. Grade to avoid a hump. Turn through. Fold the waistband to the inside and pin. Again, I like to baste this stage. We are ready to top stitch all the way around, from the front. It's difficult to know where to start. You will need 2 joins, as it's much easier to keep the jeans on the left while top stitching this stage. To finish the belt loops, work out how long you would like them. Think about the width of your belts. Measure how much you are turning in and mark the other loops. So fold up and pin in position. Use regular thread to match the top stitching. Stitch a bar tack using a narrow zigzag and short stitch length. Keep the belt loop straight. Cut off the surplus end as close as you can to the stitching. The hems. Turn up a double hem and press. Top stitch from the wrong side, as this side will be on show. The turned up cuff is looking good. Finally, the fastening. Button and buttonhole. On the waistband, left side, mark a line 2 inches, 5 centimetres from the centre front. Mark a second line 3 quarters of an inch, 2 centimetres from the centre front. I recommend a trial run. I'm using a corded foot, and I have a good length of strong thread through the hole. I have strong thread in both the needle and the bobbin. Start at the line furthest from the edge. Set your machine to needle down. Set the stitch width at 2.3 mm and the stitch length at 0.8 mm. I am pointing slightly to the left. Stop the line with the needle to the right. Change stitch length to 0.4 millimeters. Raise the foot and turn the fabric a little. Take one zigzag stitch. Do this 6 times. You will learn how much you need to turn each time. After 6, you should be pointing roughly towards the beginning. Return the stitch width to 0.8 millimeters. Straighten up a few stitches at the end. That's pretty much perfect. The button will go here, aligned with the zip. So, to repeat, start at the line furthest from the edge. The stitch width is 2.3 millimeters and the stitch length is 0.8 millimeters. I am pointing slightly to the left. Stop at the line with needle to the right. Change stitch length, 2.4 millimeters. Raise the foot and turn the fabric a little. Take one zigzag stitch. Do this 6 times. I have found this method more reliable than the automatic buttonhole stitches on my sewing machine. It is a little fiddly, but it copes much better with the heavy-duty denim. After 6, you should be pointing roughly towards the beginning. Return the stitch width to 0.8 millimeters. Straighten up for a few stitches at the end. Yes, I'm happy with that. Leave long ends to sew in. I like to use a buttonhole cutter like this. And then finish with scissors. I am using a Prim Jeans button kit. Firstly, I will make a hole that lines up with the buttonhole. I'm using a nail, but you can use an awl. Place the back stud through the hole. These supplied tools work well. Once in position, a few wallops and the button is attached. The selvage jeans are finished. Download this pattern, 10 sizes available. Visit angelacane.com/sewing-jeans. This is the fast version of this tutorial. Follow the links for the in-depth series with more detail and useful commentary. There is so much more to learn about making jeans. Visit angelacane.com for more classic sewing patterns and a full catalogue of video tutorials. Thank you for watching this super fast version.